Hey guys, it's me, Osimer, and welcome to a building tutorial that you might have seen before, but I've noticed myself how hard it actually is to build a functional micro home in The Sims 4. But there are ways to make this easier. Doing the micro home is the most difficult tier when doing tiny homes. But just in case you guys have not seen a tutorial on this yet, I am here to make your life a little bit easier. So at the first thing we're going to be doing is go into the tiny home residential option, and then we choose the micro home option, which will give us 32 tiles to work with. So we are going to start with, so as you saw there, that is 42 tiles, and we don't want to go over 32, so we are going to make this 30 tiles. Okay, so this is a box. It is 30 tiles of 32. What can we do in order to make this bigger without using tiles? So there is a very sneaky little way to do that. To do this trick, you have to individually place walls at the top now, and then we're gonna build all the way around, but not all the way. What we're gonna do is we're gonna create the piece of wall that would have gone here, so we're gonna physically just pick it up and move it. So then you have a solid box again. But now our other problem is no roof. Okay, so we're gonna use a normal block room, only one block room, and then we are going to take the roof of our choice and place it on top of that, like so. Then we bring it out. Now remember, this is still a micro home. It has not gone over 32 tiles. We are only at 31 tiles actually at the moment. So you can go ahead and remove this. I mean, you can keep it if you want to, but the micro home is not exactly very big, so you need all the space you can get. And then what we are going to do to make this house functional for at least 2 sims, okay? This might even hold 3 sims. I don't know. We'll see. So we're going to use ladders for our micro home because it's the most spacious at the moment. When you build rooms inside, you can build without taking up more tiles. As you can see at the top, you still have 31 tiles of 32 tiles. Which is awesome. This is gonna be a bathroom. Let's see what we can find over here. Okay, let's just use normal counters that are not too expensive. First of all, I just really want to put in some lighting so we can actually see what we're doing, right? So we are going to find some nice counters for our kitchen. Any counter of your choice. So we're gonna find a way to make a micro home quite functional, because micro homes are very difficult to build, and I have struggled so much. I actually started to give up on micro homes because it's just a struggle. Yeah, soon enough I found an easy way to actually make a functional micro home. So yeah, I know I'm babbling a lot. I'm just so excited to do this tutorial. So anyway, let's go on with our kitchen and we'll find everything that we need for our kitchen. So we got a stove, we got a fridge. What I would love to put in here is a smoke detector alarm, although I wish I could hide this behind the fridge. Alright, and let's just get in a sink for our kitchen. I don't know about you guys, but I'm not that obsessed with this sink because, first of all, I have a kind of a problem. I see faces in everything. I don't remember what it's called, that you, when you see a face in something, you can't unsee it. I mean, those are the eyes, those are the nose, and that's the freakishly massive mouth. And you can see down all the way into his throat. So no, I don't like that. So let's just get a normal sink, please. And our Sims will need a space in order to make their food on. This kitchen is fine enough. What you can do for extra decoration is your cabinets against your walls. Whatever works for you, works for you. What doesn't work for you, doesn't work for you, okay? So, I mean, this looks a bit too big and too fancy for this house, I know. But I mean, this is just for an example, to be honest. It's not supposed to be the real deal. So we got a very, 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 very fancy kitchen for our micro home. Okay, that's cool. So we are going to go for a dining area now. It's not very necessary to have dining tables when you have sofas to sit on and eat. So I think instead of a dining table, we are going to put down a living room space with tiny living furniture. And we shall, I'm not putting down a Murphy bed. You will never, ever, ever really see me put down a Murphy bed. Although I love it. It brings back vibes of Sims 3 University. But I'm so scared that the sim really just dies from the first try. And I know a sim doesn't die from the first try and opening it. It's just, it happens so quick by me sometimes, okay? So I'm honestly very scared of Murphy beds. Because I make sims with a purpose. I don't just want them to die on the first day, you know. So no, thank you. Okay, so we are going to put in something small. Now, this is tiny living spec, came with objects that are perfect for the small space in your home. Pet peeve, I don't like it when something is directly in the corner, just a little bit of space. I mean, that's perfect space for me. I don't like something bah in the corner. No, I don't like that. Okay, so we're going to put in our double bed because we are aiming to get two Sims living and sleeping in here, so we don't need to go with a tiny small teeny weeny bed. There's more than enough space up here, and even enough space to put side cabinets, or what are these called, end tables, at the side of the bed, which is awesome. So we put one over there, one over there, and then we can actually see now. We can probably put in another bathroom, although it's not necessary. If two Sims are living here, it's actually fine having just the one bathroom. We can though, if it's gonna be possible. Okay, now this is a very sad room. But you can, if you want, to create this into a toddler bedroom. But the only problem with toddlers is they cannot use ladders. So you will have to either go with a child or a teen or whatever, if you really want to add another to the household that you want a separate room for. But you know what? Just because I can do that, I'm gonna do that. I'm going to add a room for a child. Then we can get some wardrobes for our semi-siblings. And then I love this wardrobe from Snowy Escape. It's just, oh, it's beautiful. And then we can get a wardrobe for our child's bedroom. Okay, we shall have to go for a smaller wardrobe for the kids' bedroom. So we are going to get a bed for our child. Just something for example. There's actually a smaller wardrobe than that. There you go. Even smaller wardrobe than the other one. And then we can put in some decor for the child as well. But anyway, this is just to show you guys that two bedrooms can actually fit into a micro home, a very fancy kitchen if you want to, and a quite nice sized bathroom, which everything will also fit into. So we can go for the iconic tiny toilet, and then we can obviously, with no problem, put in a shower and a washing basin for our Sims' hands and face and teeth. And all those nice things in life. Okay, and this is a perfectly fully functional bathroom as well. We will still have space to put in some doors. Now, the thing about tiny houses is I love flooding these kind of small houses with light. So we don't need to go industrial. We can just go plain and simple. Okay, just away from the stove. Let's just put them over here. That's nice. And then we can put this one over here. Okay. And then we can choose just the way you want to arrange your windows your way. So this is basically a micro home, although it looks like a small home. It looks like a small tier. But because we had a little bit of a hack with the top floor, not taking extra tiles. Okay, so there's a little detail I just missed. For some reason, finishing this room at the top is going to take us to tiny home and not to micro home anymore. So what we can do here then, if the game really wants to be like that, and now it's just staying there. Let's just undo all of that until we have our micro option again. Beautiful. Beautiful. So if you really want to create another area for an extra sim, let's search a divider in miscellaneous decorations. Then we will find some awesome dividers that are kitty-like. We can organize a little, I mean, if you really wanted to, you can create a private little area for your children. But anyway, you guys, this is just basically a little hack to make a micro home a bigger home. So if you guys have learned anything from this tutorial, please let me know. And I will definitely make more tutorials. Building tutorials for me personally are very fun to do. I mean, this is the first time I'm doing a building tutorial. Hopefully it was helpful. And thank you very, very, very much for watching, you guys. I will see you guys very soon again. Okay, just by the way, this house looks like a chocolate. But anyway, thanks for watching, you guys. Bye-bye.